Hey guys, it's Lucan. I'm back after a 1 week break, and you're watching the New Zealand Top 40 Review.
The NZ Top 40 Review.
So this week has once again been a bit stagnant. There hasn't been a lot of major movement on the charts, and we only got two new songs. In fact, I'm starting to feel like this is going to be the norm. In fact, I think it's pretty impossible for major album bombs to happen on just a top 40. If this was a top 100, that would be more likely. Now on to the top 10, and for the fifth week in a row, seriously, I'm starting to get a bit annoyed, Peaches by Justin Bieber featuring Daniel Caesar and Giveon, which is still big on streaming and big on radio, and it looks a bit hard to break. Which is a bit of a problem, since this song has fizzled on me a bit more. At number 2 we have Montero, Call Me By Your Name, up to number 2 this week, which is still strong on streaming, and the radio is starting to appear. At number 3 we have Heartbreak Anniversary by Giveon, which I think has a huge boost in radio, which is pretty nice. It's mostly being a streaming giant because of those TikTok trends, and it's cool to see some nice organic R&B on the charts. At number 4, down from its debut, Rap Star by Polo G. While the streaming is still pretty huge, the radio isn't there yet. In fact, it's kind of hard for a rap song to become popular on the radio here in New Zealand. At number 5, we have Kiss Me More by Doja Cat and SZA, which is up as radio really is starting to like this song, and it also has pretty good streaming still. Leave the Door Open is at number 6, as it's starting to fizzle on streaming, but the radio is still pretty strong. At number 7, we have Deja Vu by Olivia Rodrigo, which is strong on streaming, and the radio is liking it a lot, which is nice since I still really love this song. It's great. Seriously, please make this a number one hit. At number 8, for the second week in a row, we have Astronaut in the Ocean by Masked Wolf, which is nice. Heat Waves is at number 9, and it's starting to fizzle on both streaming and radio, and it's had a good run. It will likely make the year end. And finally, at number 10, we have Levitating gone back into the top 10, just as one final streaming boost has happened. Well, it's had a good run as well. Let's hope it makes the year end. Okay, let's get to our losers and dropouts. So we have two dropouts, Arcade by Duncan Lawrence, which is only pretty good on the radio, the streaming isn't really there yet. And from last week, Mr. Perfectly Fine by Taylor Swift. That one was expected to be gone, and it's good because I wasn't a huge fan of that song. As for losers, there are not many major ones, with the exception of Calling My Phone by Lil TJ featuring Black, as the album boost has faded off. There are some major gains, like Fade Away by 660 went up to 33, and Sundown went up to 28. This might be because of hype for the 660 concert that recently happened. Let's see if that becomes even bigger when it's all done and over by Saturday. Anyway, let's get to our new entries, starting with...
Number 40, Friday, Dopamine Re-edit by Riton, Nightcrawlers, and Mufasa and Hypeman. It's Saturday, Sunday week, it's Friday then. It's
Saturday, Sunday week, it's Friday Well, it's about time we got this one. This is a song that's been popular around all of Europe, like the UK and Ireland. If you don't know, this is based on that Go Mufasa meme back in 2019. Seriously? We're making songs out of memes? Seriously? And I'm not gonna go into some meme lore version of Mark or anything. But seriously, ugh. Don't make songs out of dead memes. It's funny, but still, its novelty is worn off. Now let's get to the song, and oh, is that a sample of Put the Feeling On by Nightcrawlers? Seriously? That song's already been overused, like Pitbull used it for hotel room service, and I don't even like that song. And the girl singer does sound nice, and the rest of production is put with nice dark synths, and of course the classic drop from the original song. And lyrically it's about feeling good for the weekend, being excited for it, and I get the appeal of this song. The problem is, it feels cheap, and I'm not a big fan of songs that feel extremely cheap. Yeah, I'm not totally feeling this. It's alright right now, it could grow on me, but currently, solid 3 out of 10. It could grow on me, we'll just see.
Number 38, Cover Me in Sunshine by Pink and Willow Sage Hart. Tell me that the world's been spinning since the beginning, and everything will be alright.
question. Who asked for this? Seriously, this is a song that Pink made with her daughter. Seriously, that's pretty weird. Kind of strange. This is a children's song. And look, this song has been already pretty popular across the ditch. It hit top 10 there. And it's only starting to break in here in New Zealand. And what do I think of it? Well, I'm not feeling it that well. Pink sounds pretty good as always, but seriously, she should get back to doing rock. And why do this with your daughter? Look, she sounds better than most other kids singers. Looking at you, Donny Osmond. But still, feels weird. This song will likely be sang a lot in choir in the next few years. So yeah, I'm not really feeling this. Solid 2 out of 5. Sorry. And that's basically it. So yeah, Cover Me in Sunshine is getting worst of the week. It's not terrible or bad or anything, but it is kind of mediocre. And I do not like making fun of kids, so yeah, I don't really mean it. And Friday is getting beast. Next week, we're not getting Slime Language or anything that's already been locked to the hot charts. In fact, I don't really see any new songs appearing up. But I do see one new rap song that might. Anyway, you're watching Lugan TV. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Peace.